Best Friend Forever is a game that answers the question, what if Pokemon was dogs? You play as a character who just moved to the peaceful city of Rainbow Bay, in search of a new life and looking to develop their craft of photography. Right away, you're greeted by some charming DJs, friendly locals, and a few not-so-friendly locals, and are convinced by every last one of them to adopt a dog from the local shelter. The entire town of Rainbow Bay takes dog compatibility and ownership extremely seriously. To adopt a dog, and I chose Blocker, I had to work to constantly raise his stats through a series of, frankly, adorable and fun little weekly playlists. So I was prepared every time I had to go back to the surly vet to justify that I really did love and care for this dog. This all culminates in a final check-in with the vet at 15 weeks. In addition to training your dog to love you, you're also tasked with making somebody from Rainbow Bay love you. Each week, you're given a series of events that are available to choose from, enhancing your standing with your friends in Rainbow Bay, getting you closer to the sweetheart you want to smooch, or developing your dog's skills. Now, I play to win, and I wanted to make sure the harsh woman at the vet's office didn't hate me, so I spent most of my time trying to build up my dog's stats. Best Friend Forever is a game that I enthusiastically wanted to love because there's so much about it that's just cozy and good. The character and the dog designs are wonderful, and every environment in the game really seems like it was lovingly crafted. While I wish I could say this game was strong across the board, there were a few things that I experienced in my playthrough that made my visit to Rainbow Bay a little rocky. Like the same adoption paperwork for two different dogs, or my email getting stuck at three unread emails that I had definitely already read, while letting me know that I had three unread emails for the entire game. At one point, I even had two girlfriends! There's also the same issue that comes up in most dating or story sims, the vagueness of the dialogue options, where I inevitably make decisions that are completely counter to my intentions. Which wouldn't be so bad, except everyone in Rainbow Bay is kind of rude.
Idiot! Nope.
One of the characters is deliberately rude, and she's great, but everyone's flirting is pretty off-putting. Sorry, Felix. I didn't mean to say the wrong thing that made you respond like I'm trash! I wanted to really jump into the story and feel more like the character, so the lack of even simple customization options, like the ability to change hair or jacket color, was a real bummer. Overall, I had a fun time with Best Friend Forever. The aesthetic was so pleasing and the game so inclusive. It runs a quick 4 to 5 hours, and for the most part I never felt like things got too slow or boring. This is likely a game that's best played several times, in order to get the most out of the story and characters. I chose to spend my time pursuing only one or two people, while spending the rest of my energy focused on my new Best Friend Forever. But there was just so much more to do than there's time for in just one run. If you're a fan of dogs, if you're a fan of dating sims, if you like stuff that's chill and nice to look at, you'll enjoy Best Friend Forever. Anything to add, Blocker?
Oh my god.
That's stupid.
It's too cheesy. Too cheese for me.
Well, it's there if you want it.
Yeah.